you know, energy, you know, and like the Ramones and Motorhead and that type of stuff gives it that extra edge. Yeah, it's a real hard edge stuff.
We want to play the type of music, but play it hard. Mm-hmm. Not playing hard does not mean playing loud or playing fast. It's just the way you kind of deliver it, and you know, it's just different.
Now, what about the Ramones too? You got everybody's a Ramones fan.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
The music business doesn't like the Ramones. I mean.
Yeah, I have. But here's a question I can't ask any other band. What's the first time you saw the Ramones?
I seen the first tour in '77.
'77, huh?
In Wisconsin.
Yeah.
Well,
I saw. I saw.
Wait, right. only thing I get points for being the old fart that I am. I was around those days.
A lot of points for that.
You know. Well, I was 18 years old, and it was just '77 was the big year. Talking Heads put their first album out. Blondie, there was a big New York thing was going on, and I happened to be in the Midwest, and I caught some shows in Milwaukee and Chicago, and that was one I seen. Runaways were big that year.
Rock, did you see the Ramones?
I can't remember the first time I've seen him. I've seen him about 5 or 6 times, I think. But you know, the funny thing about those guys is like, every time you go see him, it's the exact same show, maybe 1 or 2 more songs, but you have such a great time.
It doesn't matter.
Whereas, you know, a lot of bands, you know, you go see, you know, like local bands, I guess, because you see them a lot, you know. After you see them 2 or 3 times, it's like, oh, that song again or this song again, you know. Yeah. Whereas somebody like the Ramones, it's just classic stuff. It's they found the perfect, you know, formula for the song, and it's great. You have a good time every time you go.
What about you, Slash?
I can count the times I've seen the Ramones. I mean, sometimes I've seen them 2 nights in a row.
Yeah.
So, what about you? You had an interesting story about the Ramones when you first saw, arguing with other people in the press.
Yeah. Well, the only thing that was real interesting about when I saw them was they were opening for the Flamin' Groovies at the Roxy, and the record was just new, and I knew the record sounded cool, but I had no idea. I mean, we were there, and you hear like 20 songs in a half hour. It was so funny and such a release, you know. Yeah. I was stunned. I was flabbergasted. It was just beautiful. And then after the show, I was writing for newspapers, and there's a lot of these kind of writer kind of guys around, the rock writers around. And I know none of them, they I think they really enjoyed it, but they were afraid to say so because they didn't know if it was cool to like it or not. I mean, I was just jumping up and I was screaming, "Do you believe that?" And people were like, "Yeah, I think that was good." Like, they got to quick read the New York papers and find out if it's...
It was cool to be a punk rocker.
Yeah.
I think that would be so cool, is like when those guys came out, because it was kind of like not a lot going on, and all of a sudden something that was just so cut and dry, just different.
Yeah. They opened the
It'd be
door
really
for everybody
exciting.
Else.
Yeah, sure.
There wouldn't have been no big things, Black Flag and all that. None of that wouldn't have happened because the English thing was different.
Yeah.
You know, the Sex Pistols and all that was a whole different type of music, and the Damned. Mm-hmm. And you know, this the Ramones kind of took all the hard edge of punk rock and made it fun.